I'm Jonathan Fanton, the president of the Academy, and it's my pleasure to welcome you and to call to order the 2013th stated meeting of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. It's wonderful to see so many people here and so many long-standing friends. So welcome on this busy holiday season. Our chair, Don Randall, and I look forward to more stated meetings across the country, reaching out to members where they live. The Academy will have programs in nearly 20 cities across the country this academic year. There are 615 members of the Academy in the New York metropolitan region, and we certainly want to do more activities here in New York. I want to thank Mark Kaplan for proposing that we live stream Cambridge-based meetings to other locations. And he hosted the live streaming of the Academy's program on Russia last month to his offices at Skadden Arps, and we thank you. And we had 60 members of the Academy there to watch a very interesting program on Russia. It was a successful experiment, and so we're going to repeat it in New York, but also extend it to Chicago, San Francisco, Washington, and other cities around the country. I hope we can form a little program committee here in New York to help plan more activities here. And indeed, there's no reason why we can't live stream what happens here back to Cambridge. I think that would be good. Fellows across the nation, including many of you, appreciate the Academy for the opportunities it provides, offering space, support, an extraordinary convening capacity that enables members of the Academy to do innovative work, often in collaboration with other members who are in fields different from their own. So let me issue an invitation tonight to each of you to suggest ways in which the Academy might be helpful to you in the work you do or on an issue you care deeply about. This evening, I'm pleased to announce the creation of a new Academy program designed for this very purpose. And this is the first time this has been said in public. Through generous gifts from several donors, including Michael Gellert and Henry Arnholt, the American Academy has created an exploratory fund to support fellows who want to meet with other fellows to look over the horizon for issues and opportunities not well understood. The fund aims to bring our fellows together to push the boundaries of what's known, think of problems in a fresh way, search for connections between research and policy that advance the common good. And you can read about this in the new electronic newsletter, so please open it next week when it comes to your emails. In addition to proposing new topics for study, you may also choose to participate in one of our existing studies, and let me mention two that require help in following up. Last month, we released the report on American science policy entitled Restoring the Foundation. The report advocates a larger federal and philanthropic investment in basic research, research that may not yield immediate results, but that may in the long run prove transformative. And Restoring the Foundation follows the heart of the matter, another important report of the Academy of a Commission on the Humanities and Social Sciences. And since June 2013, the Commission has been engaged in a public campaign to advocate a broad education for all Americans, an education that draws deeply on the humanities and social sciences, as well as STEM fields. There are copies of these reports available, I think, just outside, and so be sure to pick them up. And we need help in taking the work of Academy committees and getting it well known, and you all can play a role in that. The Academy, through this newsletter, will be giving you advance notice of projects that are in formation in the hope that you'll be interested in participating. Let me mention two. We've just launched a project, just had our first meeting, on looking at how technology changes the way we think about fighting a war using force in an ethical manner. And it's that's a wonderful academy group, because you have a Michael Walzer, philosopher, who wrote Just and Unjust Wars, sitting alongside of the admiral who commanded the Mediterranean fleet during the NATO-Kosovo bombing of Kosovo. And there's what the academy can do to bring scholars, intellectuals, but also people in business and the military and the government together to look at a really difficult problem. Our humanities report was well received in the Congress, and just last week, four senators and four members of the House wrote a letter to us asking that we form a follow-up commission to look at the state of foreign language instruction here in the United States. And so that will be another project that we will be undertaking. But not all member engagement comes through these formal studies. The Academy also offers, through Daedalus, a venue for individual scholars or small groups of members to get together and express their own ideas in writing. Since 2008, every Daedalus issue now is guest edited by an Academy Fellow. The very first issue published under this new system was on judicial independence, edited by Linda Greenhouse. That issue was also the subject of a stated meeting here in New York in November 2008, featuring Linda, but also Judith Resnick and Justice Sandra Day O'Connor. In her remarks that evening, Justice O'Connor invoked the words of Academy founder John Adams, who wrote, and I quote, "It is essential to the preservation of the rights of every individual to be tried by judges as free, impartial, and independent as the lot of humanity will admit." Well, Justice O'Connor that night argued that thoughtful scholarship widely disseminated by institutions like the Academy can be a safeguard against injustice. And so this summer's issue of Daedalus, The Invention of Courts, is part of a long-standing Academy interest in our legal system. It's an important contribution to an ongoing conversation about the nature of the courts and their relationship to what the editors call the society we hope to be. So to begin our program, it's my pleasure to introduce Judith Resnick, the Arthur Lyman Professor of Law at Yale and co-editor of Invention of the Courts. She'll offer some preliminary remarks, introduce the rest of the panel. We'll then at some point open it up to the audience, and by 8:30 we'll be on our way. Judith.